I'm Dr. Alexandra DeGroot. I'm an audiologist and I'm the owner of Hearing Ally. Today, I want to go over the mechanisms of the ear and the different types of hearing loss. So, there are two main types of hearing loss, conductive and sensorineural. Now, there's a third type, but it's really just a mixture of the first two, and it's called a mixed hearing loss. So, we're just going to talk about one and two today. The first one, conductive hearing loss, means that there's a blockage in the outer or middle ear preventing conduction of sound into the inner ear up to the brain. So, conductive hearing loss, block in the conduction of sound. Sensorineural hearing loss is a hearing loss that resides in the sensory or neural portion of the ear. So, usually it's actually the sensory portion, the inner ear, the cochlea, where sound is turned into an electrical signal and transmitted to the auditory nerve. So this is the most common type of hearing loss, especially in adults. It's the hearing loss we associate with aging, noise exposure, or exposure to toxic chemicals. So that's just a quick overview. Let's go through the anatomy of the ear to help us understand those two types of hearing loss, okay? So, we've got our trusty ear here. Of course, why would I have an enormous ear? I'm an audiologist, so this was like the best gift that my husband could have ever given me. So when we think of the outer ear, it's the part that we can see, the pinna, as well as the ear canal all the way up to the eardrum. That's this little piece of tissue right here. So the outer ear is where you can get earwax buildup. You can also have an infection in there, or like swimmer's ear. And sometimes there are different kinds of birth anomalies that make it so that this space is blocked, but the rest of the auditory system is functioning normally. So any kind of blockage in the outer ear can cause a conductive hearing loss. The next part is the middle ear. It's a little bit hard to see from this main view, but I just want you to understand that it's going from the out to the inside, and the middle ear starts here at the eardrum, actually the other side of the eardrum, and then there's these three little bones that are connected to that. So I'm actually going to take this out here, if I can. So you've got the eardrum itself, and then in this case, we've got two of those bones connected to the eardrum. The third bone is attached here to this, the inner ear. See that little thing projecting out there that looks like a stirrup on the top? That's the third bone that's part of the middle ear. Okay, so we're gonna put this one back. You can also see inside of here that there is like this space where these little bones sat, okay? And that space in a real human is filled with air and encased in bone. So, just got this kind of lid on it there inside. So that space can get filled with fluid. And when we think about a kid having an ear infection, we're usually talking about a middle ear infection. So a lot of times people will say inner ear infection because it's deep inside of the ear, but it's not actually the inner ear, it's the middle ear. So if you've got fluid buildup in here, scar tissue on the eardrum, damage to these little bones, all of those types of disorders may cause a conductive hearing loss. Okay, blockage of the sound to the inner ear. Okay, so that makes sense when we look at how the sound travels to the inner ear, through that bone right there. So it has to get all the way through, vibrate through the air in the ear canal, then be transmitted on the eardrum through those three little bones, and then vibrate this space, which goes into this kind of coil-shaped organ, the cochlea, okay? When the sound travels through there, it vibrates fluid inside of the cochlea. And then the cochlea has little hair cells, which you may have heard of before. I kind of like to think of them as like seaweed in the ocean. So when a wave of sound comes through the ocean, it knocks over those hair cells or that seaweed. And that triggers an electrochemical signal, basically just an impulse to the nerve that tells that specific pitch region or frequency region of the cochlea to the nerve that a sound was detected right there, okay? Then we see the auditory nerve right here. that nerve delivers the sound up to the higher auditory processing centers of the brain. So they're obviously on both sides, and those auditory centers can get quite complex. They actually can go from the right side of the brain over to the left and back again. And there are all sorts of interesting networks that are created in there and how we process and understand sound. But it all starts with this part of the ear, okay? So a sensorineural hearing loss is the part that includes that auditory nerve, but really we're not talking about the brain in this case. We're talking about just sensing sound, okay? Sensorineural in the cochlea or in the auditory nerve, okay? So I hope that made sense. If you guys have questions, please put comments below. I hope you're having a good one.